And we are joined this morning with some students affiliated with the NFJC. This is Mariana and Mariama and Dylan. Thanks for joining us this morning. Mariama, let me ask you, you are a junior at Canisius. When
yes.
you watched this, what did you feel? What was your initial reaction? It got you right from the opening scene, didn't it?
Yeah, I think with anything, seeing a human being treated like that, and especially at my age now, you get that sense of almost like mortality and understanding, you know. You expected them to have empathy for him, and the fact that you just left him there and the way they treated his body is like, how could you do that to another human being, you know, and not think, I need to call 911 or I need to get help. Especially if they're supposed to be brothers, is that sense of community. You don't help your community, you just let them be there like that.
Because they waited almost an hour before they called 911.
Yeah, now Dylan, you're still in high school, so obviously you haven't had that college party experience.
Yeah.
Were you surprised at what you saw? What were your initial reactions?
I was kind of a little surprised. I mean, nowadays you really hear stories of kids getting hurt and by stupid drinking and stuff like that. But, I mean, I used to be persuaded and stuff like that all the time. So, I mean, I kind of know
what the peer pressure angle is, maybe in a scenario like that.
Yeah.
Mariama, do you think that students in Western New York could relate to what they saw? I mean, either from a culture standpoint of what the drinking was all about, and also just the behavior of the students?
I think the fact that it's like, there was a scene that said it would never be me, because everyone thinks drinking is okay because it's not drugs, but no one ever thinks of alcohol as a drug. So it's okay. It's okay to keep drinking. It's okay to take, you know, that whiskey shot until you're like almost blackout drunk. Nobody cares about that. And I think the fact that once we start associating alcohol with being a drug and something that can be harmful to your body is a time when kids would start to wake up. You know, we already have bans on like flavored jewels and stuff like that, you know, tobacco companies, and they're already targeting our young folks.
Mm-hmm.
And now the alcohol is just, you know, accessible to anybody. It's easy, you know, it's easy for high schools to go to parties with people who are like 21 who are in college, and they buy and they just have to pay $5 for a red cup.
Sure.
And that gives you ultimate refills.
Dylan,
yeah.
Let me ask you, being in high school, how important, what would you say to other kids out there that have not watched this, why they should watch this prior to going to college?
I mean, lots of accidents happen. Kids think that just because bans are being put on that it's still okay to do that stuff, but I really think that they should watch this and actually learn things from it, because it could help their life be better.
That's right, and save a life too.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
All right. We appreciate your sharing your insight with us today.
Mariama, Dylan, thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.